NASA put together a team of their best and brightest engineers to design a spacecraft capable of exploring the unique and technically challenging oceans of this liquid world. And after a number of false starts and dead ends, they came up with this, a submarine.
I was reading 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. I thought, you know, Titan has this wonderful groups of seas. What's underneath there?
If you can get below the surface of the sea and get all the way down to the bottom in certain areas and actually touch the silt that's on the bottom and sample it and learn what that's made of, it'll tell you so much about the environment that you're in. But if you have a boat that just drives on the surface, figuring out how to get a probe all the way down to the bottom, get that sample all the way back up to the surface and sample it, really becomes an intractable problem. There's so many things that could go wrong doing that. And instead, we said, if we could encapsulate everything together in a submarine, then we could go right down and do that sampling and come all the way back up to the surface.
But sailing a large one-tub sub around Titan's super-cold methane-rich seas isn't without its problems. Fortunately, NASA has the technology to replicate conditions on the freezing moon, and this is it. Inside this huge tank, scientists can safely and accurately mix up the highly volatile cocktail of chemicals that make up the atmosphere of the huge moon. They have discovered that one of the biggest problems of Titan's methane seas is that they're rich in nitrogen, and that could make it very difficult to maneuver.
There could be so much nitrogen dissolved in the sea that when the propellers turn on our jets, it might just make a lot of bubbles and not be able to push against the liquid. So we're doing analysis now, and we hope to do some testing in the near future that shows us what happens if you spin a propeller in liquid methane, in liquid ethane, with lots of nitrogen dissolved in it, and can you get any thrust out or not? This is a really important question to answer.
The sub will be packed full of scientific instruments and teeming with cameras. But there's one thing the scientists feel will make the mission more than anything else.
That first picture, are you kidding? That first picture from a submarine, from anybody's submarine on the surface of a sea on another planet in our solar system, changes the world. I mean, that's something that none of us have ever seen before. That is true discovery. That is why we do any of this. And that would be awesome. That first picture alone would make this entire mission worth it.